Hello everyone and welcome back to Skyrim. As you can see, me and my party are back in Falkreath and we're just going to have to act as if the skeletons are not roaming around because obviously I would not have them come into the town because that would be like, hey, look at me, I'm a necromancer, come and kill me. So I got some advice from YouTube user Shradak, and I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly, and his comment was that if I wanted to roleplay it, that I heard about a bloodlet throne that could assist me with my undead necromantic arts. And I believe, if this is the place I'm thinking of, I believe it's like a tower located somewhere around here, and we'll assume that the rumors told me that the tower is up here, but from my personal experience, I think the bloodlet throne is up here. So, we came back to sell off some of our equipment, and now we are going to head off towards where we think this bloodlet throne is, and hopefully find some additional information or maybe some techniques on how to summon more effective undead. Also, hopefully I'll be able to test out our new acquisition, the armored spell skeleton, or armored mage skeleton guy. Alright, so let me actually look at my map and kind of plot this course. Where do I want to go? I guess I'm going to want to go down the road up into... You know what? Should I just go out of Falkreath through this way? Nah, we'll just go this way. Okay. So yes, we were heading up to this bloodlet throne in hopes of finding more knowledge. I don't believe that's the road. Let's keep going. What the heck?
I am waiting for a good death.
Maik and an old orc and a couple of saber cats. Alright. I won't question it. This is not the place we're looking for, but ruins do sometimes hold secrets. Just in case there may be... Oops, that's not what I wanted. Some nasty people hiding in there. Let me do that. And we will have the Armored Skeleton Mage on... Let's do three? Let's do two. We'll put these flames on three. And the Imperial Iron War Staff... Is that the one I wanted? That's the one I favorited. I don't think that's the one I wanted, though. That's 35. Yeah. So we want that. And we'll make... Well, I may not assign that an actual number yet, but I need to do the reanimation as well. So let's see, we have Hunting Pack 1, Skeleton Mage 2. I'll put this as 3 and then that as 4. And then F1 does Fear and the Bound Dagger. Yeah, okay, so that works. Although I forgot to summon my mage. So let me put that in my hand. Okay, so does this old tower hold any secrets? It holds a dead Spriggan. What the heck? Okay.
Speak.
Holy sh... Whoa, don't sneak up on a necromancer with a Daedric summoned dagger. Alright, well anyway, that looks pretty cool. Who are you?
You have something to say. Well, save your breath. The way I see it, you don't have much more of them left.
Wait, How would Gerson respond to that? A proud Nord. You should be careful who you threaten.
It wasn't a threat, fool. But it can be. Seem tired is all, out of breath.
What is your name?
Son of Cloud Ruler Temple, named me the Desert Fang. The Thalmor know me as Descuria. To you, I am simply Zvashni, the Khajiit who spared your life.
Interesting. Where do you hail from, brash one?
Cyrodiil, fool.
Hey, now.
The steps of Cloudwilla Temple. From whence I came before that, no one knows. A blade who had left the service found me as he descended the steps. To him it was a sign from the Divines. In truth, it was just a cowardly mother, waiting for the opportune time, and a man with forlorn eyes. Having left the Order, his eyes were indeed tainted with sorrow, and for that he pitied this kitten when he should have abandoned it. Yet it was his newly discovered faith in the workings of the gods that inspired him to develop the skills for which I'm the caretaker.
Okay. Interesting. Sounds like fate to me.
The world is full of such tales of fate and coincidence. That's what we burn into our memories. And all the other instances. Every day we live without incident. Those moments are never ascribed to the laziness of the gods. Just forgotten.
Tell me about your armor and sword.
Akaviri, forged in the Dragonland. Did a sword and armor of the blades, sworn to the service of the true Emperor. But know this, my sword serves no one. You could be Tiber Septim reborn, and I'll still send you back to the Divines with your head in your arms.
Okay. Which one do I go for? Yeah, it sounds like something a warrior Skyrim could say. If you're a blade, you ought to seek revenge, not hide away like a coward.
I kill Thalmor not for revenge, but to survive.
Hey, I kill Thalmor. Well.
The Order died the day they chose not to acknowledge the Emperor. Only the strong have the right to be masters of their own destiny. Without the Empire, the Blades are just a guild of half-wits playing dress-up. Like fools, they hold themselves up in their temple like flies in a jar. All the Thalmor did was turn it over and cut off the heir. If the Emperor looked in the eyes of the hundred heads in that cart, would have seen half of them were malnourished and on the brink of starvation. 100 heads of 100 fools. I seek no vengeance for those who can't save themselves from a flock of robed toads.
Wow. I'm trying to see how we could possibly recruit this as an ally, because she obviously does not like Thalmor. She. And I'm no fan either. If you're looking for a fight, Skyrim's as good a place as any.
What you consider a fight, or even a war, is nothing more than a brawl between drunken louts over spilled drink. A great swordsman's talents are wasted in a war. Stray arrows, trebuchets, accidents. Many great warriors have been felled by the Blade of Chaos. One can't even trust his own side in the haze of war. Who's to say who's friend or foe, when your eyes squint through geysers of dirt and smoke? Like your queries, they range from the utterly pointless to the completely meaningless.
Yeah, okay. The valorous Nords who fill the Hall of Sovngarde would beg to differ.
Your blood boils hot, Nord. Perhaps it will attract a horde of vampires. At least then there will be someone here that presents a challenge.
Then why stay in Skyrim?
Another simple query from a devout simpleton. The answer is tall, green, robed, and uglier than an imp. The Thalmor's tentacles extend all across Tamriel, but in Skyrim, their presence is weak. While they are busy protecting their vital organs, they will bleed out from their wrists with every Justicar I slay on the road below.
Okay, well, I don't think she is going to help us.
Be gone, then.
I'll come back, though. I won't give up.
Out with it, fool.
Because she seems pretty cool. And she hates Thalmor, I hate Thalmor, even though she's kind of rude. I could possibly use her in the future. That's pretty cool. Must be another one of the interesting NPCs. Okay, so we want to... Actually... Yeah, we're almost to the road we want, I think. Huh. It's the first time I've ever seen that person. That was pretty cool. Let's see, so have bandits repopulated this place? No. Good. Huh, really, Skyrim? Really? You're just gonna crash on me, huh? Oh! Man! Sorry for the black screen, everybody. I'm reloading my game. Okay. That sucks. That really sucks. But hey, at least we weren't that far from Falkreath. I guess it won't be too difficult to make that small journey again. Oh my god. Does not build Oh shit, I'm outside the cave still. Hey, there's more armored skeleton mage. You know what? Would it be faster just go from Helgen? And then just go up the road? Maybe. Trying to make up for lost time now. God, I cannot believe that. Just randomly crashed! I'm just running down the road! Get off the road! Is this what I want to be? Yes. Yes it is. Okay. So we'll just go up this way instead. So yeah, sorry about that. If you watched my Adventures in Skyrim, you're probably used to things like that happening, but I wasn't expecting crashes to happen this early in the series. I'm using a lot of different mods this time, so maybe some of them are conflicting and just randomly crashing the game, I guess. If that's the case, then that really sucks. I don't want to be sidetracked by random caves. I want to go to the Bloodlet Throne. Whoa. Why did all everything get all blurry? What the hell? What in the heck? My screen is just really blurry. Obviously you can tell. What in the hell? Now it's cleared up, but that was strange. That was very strange. Am I still going the right way? I think I am. Yeah, I think I want to go... It's like either there... I think it's there. So let's keep going. Yeah, it seems like I got hit with the poison or something. Just randomly, and it was blurring my screen. Then it just kind of cleared itself up. Okay. There we go. I think that's it on my radar. Compass, whatever. I guess it's not radar. It's not really a technology that would have been discovered in Skyrim. But compasses, sure. Whoa. What is up with... Hello?
I am waiting for a good death.
I know.
You should have killed that one. Didn't use the blade very well.
Again, I don't want to be sidetracked. Someone else will give you a death, I'm sure. Aha. There's the tower. Snowberry. Bloodlet Throne. Okay. So, this has to be the place that we have heard about. Doesn't appear to be anyone outside. Alright, you guys ready? Looks like this time none of my skeletons wished to accompany me. Do I have any? Ooh, what does that activate? Probably those things.
Someone there?
Stinks in here. How can people live in these moldering old forts?
Look at have any more? I need more materials. Okay. Oh shit. Vampires. Well, if I'm learning something about death, it wouldn't make sense that it'd be from a vampire. Go get him, Wolfies. Or not.
Wouldn't be so lucky again.
Oh shit, right, I forgot they can raise back up if I don't kill them with like fire or sun magic or something. Cleanse with garlic. Oh, I like the garlic. Well, how about we do this? We just harvest her instead. That'll make her go away. Do you keep stepping on that trap, dude? Okay, so it looks like we took care of some of the sentries. Hello, Wolfie. Armored mage, right. And I need to redo that, don't I? Yes. So you're two... Reanimation is 3. Yep. That will be 4 or 5. Okay. Excellent. Now, I have been here before, so I believe... Yep, there it is. Wow, you're actually affected by fear, huh? That is, don't follow it through the fire. Alright, Brock, let's go.
Nice team.
Does that thing even cast spells? Ooh. Can I harvest you? No. Whoa. That's nasty. I mean, I'm a necromancer, but that looks like someone's been eating that. I don't eat. Ooh. Materials for my future alchemy, whenever I get around to it. Okay, I'm not done with the other rooms, so let's go back. And my armored mage is now gone. Is there anything back here? Just some bones, huh? And if memory serves, obviously Gerstner wouldn't know, but that's locked. Yes. That is the exit. Okay. Let's finish clearing out this room. Sure, take that. Sea ghosts. Probably should quick save. In case the game decides to randomly crash, or I die. Oh, I remember this place. Oh, if this is affected by the populated mod, oh, this is gonna suck. I don't know if I was ever here with Adventures in Skyrim series, but man, this room sometimes just sucks. Alright, you guys, go on ahead. Go on without me, I'll be right behind you. I promise. promise. Yeah, there you go. Especially since these guys have to be killed by, like, fire.
Where to next, friend?
No. I'm trying to harvest before she rises. Although I guess it doesn't really make sense during a fight, does it? Alright, I won't do that. Oh, shoot. Oh, we're all right.
Who wants to die first?
Way to go in there, Nadina. Although Nadina is almost... what the hell? Ouch. Okay. Well, that was... That was fun. Let's try to make sure that doesn't happen again. Ah, damn it. Oh, they resist the fear. I guess that makes sense. Oh, she may come back. Can I just burn you now? Aw, damn it. Guys, you're leaving a mess back here. Alright.
I love it when you get squashed right into my heart.
You vampires will wish the sun had got you.
I really hate burning my own people, but... Oops, search, I guess. Ooh. Alright, so who shot me with that arrow? Was it the guy I was shooting fire at? It probably was. So I need to make sure that these guys are at least... Oh, I didn't even see him that time. Oh. Shit. You know what? Am I on adept or am I on... Okay, I'm on expert. Let me load that to adept. I'm tired of getting one-shot by arrows. Alright, here we go again. At least I quicksaved right there, or else this would be really annoying. What the hell was that? Okay, hopefully she is dead. Are you dead? I think they're dead. Where are these, like, random fireballs coming from? There you are. You're the bastard who hit me with the arrow, aren't you? Oh, shoot. Thank you, Skeleton Mage. Oh, my. Where are these coming from? These, like, random fireballs. Oh, my God, it's Sokka. Adina, everybody is just... Is it this guy? Is he throwing out fireballs? There we go. Are you killing everybody, Skeletal Mage? Bad Skeletal Mage. Bad. Alright, we'll take that. Let's clear out this room. I probably should have taken the dust. Ooh, nice. Got a lot from her. There was someone else I killed, like, right here, right? Search vampire. That's funny. I'm harvesting a sword. Now the vampire's body probably got blown away somewhere. Nice job, everybody. Let's quick save.
Dungeon's too good for Langdon. Death too.
I just hope this isn't too easy on Adept. That was why I kept on Expert for so long, but I hate just getting one shot by an arrow. Who knows, maybe I still will on Adept. Okay. Take all that. Ooh. I love how they decorated the place. Ooh, Greater Soul Gem. Okay. Do I want to go in there? Maybe? I guess I can give it a try. Come on, give it to me. So close. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Thank goodness. Okay. So we got some gold, got a potion. Cabbage. What the heck do vampires need with cabbage? Ooh, I'll take that. That's worth it. That seems pretty worth it. Take all those, take that. Scroll of Blizzard. Scroll of Fury. Reverent Iron Dagger. Don't want the carrots. Okay. I'd say that was worth it. And that's the room we just came from. I don't think this goes anywhere. Nope. Whoa. The heck was that? Ah, yes. Okay. I remember this place. Let me slap on some good old oak flesh. Hello? How do we... Ah, yes. Here we go. Activate chain. Oh, shoot. Guys, there's like a... Oh.
Looky here. Looks like we got ourselves a hero. Again.
Oh, boy.
Stones. No, just kidding. That didn't hurt. Hey, you look good coming in blood.
Skull dead and buried.
There's another one of those, like, flame blasts. What the hell? Wow, this guy is just taking the fire. I suppose I could probably just duel that. Nice. Okay. Wait a minute. Did my armored mage summon another armored mage? Is that what just so happened? Brock, did you see that? You don't talk much. Interesting. Probably would have died if that was on expert. Which again may be a problem. Because I still want it to be kind of challenging. Is there like a chest somewhere around here? Maybe it's further on. Hello? There we go. Okay. Ah. There you are. Okay, we have a shield of resist frost, robes of destruction, orcish dagger. I That is unfortunate. Well, we did get to harvest some vampires. We got some ingredients for possible future alchemical needs. That's about it. Got some random weapons here and there. But unfortunately, we did not learn much to further our necromancy. But, you know, every single encounter matters. It brings us closer to higher level for our character. It brings us closer to fully understanding necromancy by having to constantly summon more, you know, armored mages and such. So, there we go. We have cleared the Bloodlet Throne, which is filled with vampires. I'm sure the locals in Falkreath will appreciate that, even though that wasn't my intention. But there you go. So thanks for watching this episode, everybody, and I will see you all next time. Take care.